Hi, and welcome to this first video of Appian's Offline Mobile YouTube series. In this video, you will learn what offline mobile is, how it works, and two guiding principles to follow when designing for offline mobile. Let's get started. You develop responsive, adaptive, and engaging interfaces for your users. But what happens when someone's internet access is unstable or not available at all? With offline mobile, users can complete their work seamlessly with offline actions and tasks, whether they are online or not. Let's take a closer look at offline mobile's capabilities. First, users can complete offline actions, allowing them to initiate a process. Second, users can review and complete user input tasks assigned to them. Both of these capabilities can be done whether the user is online or has lost internet connectivity. To get a better understanding, let's look at an example to see how offline mobile works for a user on the go. Meet Kim. Kim works for a rental management company. Each day, she travels to multiple homes across the city and inspects each part of the house to ensure they are in good shape before a renter moves in or moves out. Most days at Kim's inspection sites, Kim does not have access to the internet. This is a big issue for Kim since she needs to access the company's inspection form out in the field. Before Kim leaves the office to go to the first inspection site, she signs into her Appian mobile application while connected to the internet. Kim sees the inspection form right away because it is the start page for Kim's team. She refreshes it by pulling down on it. This ensures the most recent data is cached on Kim's phone so the form can be loaded when she is offline. Kim then heads out for the day and arrives at her first home inspection site. The house does not have Wi-Fi access, but that won't affect Kim's workflow. Kim opens the inspection app and navigates to the move-in, move-out form on her phone. As Kim inspects the house, she inputs data into each field of this form. The interface will reevaluate locally on Kim's device. When Kim is done inspecting, she submits the form. If Kim is still offline, then the form goes into a pending state. When Kim does have internet access, the form is submitted. For Kim, she was able to input data into the form and click submit just like she would any other Appian form. Now let's take a look behind the scenes to see how offline mobile was able to help Kim complete her work. When Kim was at home and was connected to the internet, she made sure the necessary data was available for her to access while disconnected. The values from local variables that were loaded at the beginning of that interface's expression were downloaded and cached onto her mobile device. When Kim was at the inspection site, she input data into the form. The data on the form reevaluated based on Kim's input. Kim did not need to be online for that reevaluation to occur. It's important to note that only compatible and partially compatible functions in the Appian functions table are supported in offline forms. If you need to use partially compatible functions, you will need to load them in local variables at the top of the interface expression. Kim's input was stored on the device. Since Kim was still offline, the form went into a pending state. When Kim had an online connection, the form was submitted. The server replayed all user interactions to ensure consistency, and then moved to the next node in the process model, in this case, a write to data store entity smart service. As you can see, mobile offline helps Kim and her team review tasks and take action. You can enable offline mobile whenever your users need offline actions and tasks, but can't rely on a consistent internet connection. So what should you know when designing for offline use? In this video, we will cover two guiding principles to keep in mind when using offline mobile. First, if offline is a requirement, then you should design for offline first. Offline-enabled interfaces work when the user is connected to the internet or not. This enables a consistent user experience and ensures data loss is avoided if the device loses internet connectivity. And second, an offline-enabled interface is the backbone for offline tasks and actions, and when designing your offline-enabled interface, it's important to remember that all necessary offline data must be loaded to the interface before the user starts using it. In this video, you learn that offline mobile allows your users to complete offline actions and tasks whether they are online or not. you met an offline mobile user, Kim, and learned how she interacted with an offline mobile form. You also took a look behind the scenes to see how an offline mobile interface works. Finally, you learned two design best practices to keep in mind if offline mobile fits your use case. If you enjoyed this video and want to learn more, check out the next video of this series to learn how to build and test offline-enabled interfaces.